and it's an NFL football game, I got the Cowboys plus 10.
You do?
Yeah.
Well, this opened at 9.5, and people quickly bet it down to 7.5. That's a major plummet.
Vegas right been there. Taking a hit. They took a hit last night.
They did.
Remember, I told you, Skip, I said,
you were right.
63 points is
all. Right. You're right about that, but you were wrong about the outcome.
Whatever.
Well, whatever.
You always nitpick.
Would you rather do the over-under or who wins and loses? I'll take the winner.
I would take the over-under and bet the over-under.
Okay.
Okay.
This spread scares me to death. What do you always tell me, Mr. Sharp, about division rivalries? And this might be number one. This is the top of my list because I covered so many Dallas at Washington and Washington at Dallas games. It is a blood rivalry. Mm. It levels the playing field. I don't care how wounded Washington is. I have watched that team closely all year. It plays with grit. It plays with mental toughness. It plays with backbone. It will scratch. It will claw. It will compete. It will battle. That's who this team is. That's what it's made of. And I respect it. What happened at Washington? 20-17 happened. It almost went to overtime. There was a bogus robbery of a call made on my snapper that he somehow flinched or moved the football. He did not move the football. He did exactly what he's done for 14 years. And they called it and sent my kicker back 5 more yards, and he hit the left upright, or it would have been overtime. But it was 20-17. I promise you this is going to be close, low scoring. It'll be in that 20-17 neighborhood. That was the score of the night. Colt McCoy, back in 2014, on October 27th, went to Dallas and beat the Cowboys at Jerry World. Colt McCoy from the University of Texas. Yep. Small town Texas kid.
Okay.
Coach's kid.
I give you 8.5.
Well, I'm not going to bet against Dallas.
No, I'm going to give you the points.
Yeah.
You take Dallas, but I'm going to give you, they're going to win by more than 8.5.
Okay. We'll do that on Thursday morning because we got a show on Thursday morning. So the point is that Colt McCoy hadn't even played in a long time. You have to go back to 2016, last time he even attempted a pass.
I didn't know he was still in the league, to be honest, until he came off the bench.
But you know what? This is another one of those guys who was just born ready. That's what he is. He's just a quarterback by name. He grew up a quarterback. He will be ready. I promise you he will play well. That night in 2014, he went 25 of 30 for 299, and they won in overtime 20-17. So he will play well enough. He will keep them in the game. And what about that running back? Is he from small town Texas called Palestine, just down the road from Dallas? I'm talking about Adrian Peterson. And he's going to be back at Jerry World on the Texas stage on Thanksgiving Day with the world tuned
short
in.
Short turnaround, Skip.
Huh? But you old don't think he's going to cover. Yeah, but you watch. He's going to do it with his heart.
Skip. You said you believe in the Cowboys' defense.
I do, but I'm just going to be close, low scoring. I also believe in the Washington defense. I think it's really good.
First of all, I don't believe Washington, with what they're missing, can get to a number high enough to beat the Cowboys. If the Cowboys get to 20, the ball game's over. But I believe they'll get upwards of that. I believe they'll get in the high 20s, maybe even low 30s. I don't believe this game will be close.
The Houston Texans needed a pick six from, 104 yards?
Right.
To win that game, they barely, 23-21? That's what's going to happen. It's going to be in that ballpark.
Cowboys lost to the Texans, but they are a different team now, Skip. They're playing with a lot. I think that win, if the Cowboys were to go on a run here, make the playoffs, everybody's going to look back to what they did on that Sunday night in Philly.
Sure.
That was the turning point.
Oh, was it?
Because if they lose that game, it's over, Skip.
I totally agree.
So I believe they're a different team now. And with banged up offensive line, Randy Gregory and Crawford and DeMarcus Lawrence, they're going to be hunting. Old tackling Dutchman going to try to keep it 300 games in a row with a pick. So now.
I remind you, the Redskins are still in first place in the NFC East. And I remind you that they keep playing close, tight games. They didn't exactly roll over and die against the Houston Texans, who have now won, what is it, up to? Are they
like
up to
6 games?
Yeah. Okay. So it's a rivalry. It's Thanksgiving. It will be tight. I believe Dallas will win the game because Dallas really needs to win the game. I believe it will be tied in the NFC East after this game, and I believe they're poised for takeoff. But the 7.5, again, if I were completely objective about this and I didn't have any ties to the Dallas Cowboys, I would jump at that. I'd take those points in a second.
Well, I'm going to give them to you.
Okay.
Cowboys will win by like 11, 12.
11 or 12?
Yep.
You're just trying to jinx them, and I want the world to know that you've lost twice in a row by trying to...
Skip, I'm not trying to jinx them, but you keep telling me that the Cowboys defense, they have a top two scoring defense, and Dak and Zeke, you told me Dak's the guy now. You told me Dak is figuring it out. Okay, then, so what's the problem?
The problem is Washington. I've seen too many of these.
So who's going to block? Me and you and Jenny? Jenny got to catch a flight. So she's unavailable to play guard.
Bill Callahan is the second best offensive line coach I've ever been around, because the first best just came out of retirement to fix my offensive line, Hudson Houck. Well, so that Bill Callahan, that's another guy.
I'm the best.
Huh?
Starnecchio says I'm the best.
He's up there.
Alex Gibb says I'm the best.
That was back in your day.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, Alex.
Yeah, okay, I got it. But Bill Callahan is no joke, and he will have them as ready as they can be to play. This will be a battle.
Skip their backup. Yeah,
this will be the complete opposite of what you saw last night.
Yeah.
Complete opposite.
Yeah, because they're quarterbacks.
Low-scoring battle.
Did you realize those quarterbacks that's playing last night?
Mm-hmm.
Now, what's going to be very interesting to me, Skip, is that in a couple of weeks, they're going to have them on Pro Bowls. Somebody getting left home.
Mm.
I don't know who it's going to be, but you only take three.
Mm. On which side?
AFC and NFC.
Yeah.
I know my homeboy going.
Mm.
I believe Roethlisberger going.
Okay.
Now, Andrew Luck playing really, really well.
He is. So?
That's been good to see.
Hey, he ain't going to be looking good.
You know what? I hope he gets left at home.
You want that thing to burn so you know he's going to have something to prove.
Because when he gets a mad on, you better look out. We're talking about Tom Brady here.
He wouldn't be deserving. Mm-hmm. You think he deserves it? As we currently sit here, do you think he's deserving?
Yeah, I do. To have that team at 7-3, that sorry team that's around him.
To go over who? You know Andrew Luck is playing unbelievable.
I'll take him over Andrew Luck.
Oh, you take him over my homeboy?
No.
What about Big Ben?
No.
Uh-oh.
Three.
So it's going to come down to Andrew Luck and Big B and Tommy.
I'm rooting for Andrew Luck because Brady needs that motivation.
He don't need no motivation. Hold on. What about Phillip Rivers?
Mm-hmm.
Phillip Rivers is like 25, like 22-3.
He just lost at home to Case Keenum.
Hold on. You lost at home to Marcus Mariota.
Mm-hmm. So what's that? I'm not making a case for Dak being a pro.
No.
Huh?
Tom Brady lost.
Oh, that was at Tennessee.
Yeah,
that's what you're talking about?
Lost. Okay. And you lost to Blake Bortles. To anybody that loses to Blake Bortles, you shouldn't go to the Pro Bowl for the rest of your life.
Huh.
And if you, whatever
I
you
think want. Bill Belichick lost.
Don't do
to
that,
Blake
Skip.
Bortles.
Okay, Matthew
Am I
Stafford.
Right?
What about Matthew Stafford?
Bill Belichick lost to Matthew Stafford. He threw for like 400 yards.
So what is Tom Brady? So when does Tom Brady get any blame?
Mm. He needs some credit because he never gets any.
You know, Jenny, you know that too.
I like Brady.
I like Brady too, but he's not.
You hate Brady.
But
he lied.
But he bears culpability.
You just told the biggest lie.
No, I like Brady. I like Brady.
Oh yeah,
I like Brady.
I'm going back to the Thanksgiving game. I'm excited to be working with you guys on Turkey Day. That should be fun.
We're going to be
right here.
You're not
working with us. Oh, you are.
I'll be here. I'm not going to miss Thanksgiving. That's a big day.
I thought we were going to have to go play offensive line for the Redskins.
No, probably not. The Cowboys though have yet to beat a team over 500. I know Redskins are injured, but something to keep in mind. And another team under 500, Aaron Rodgers. Mm-hmm.